In this video, we're going to be looking at the shape and grain section. So the first thing we're going to look at here is the shape. So shape, this is a 512 by 512 image. This is a PNG image. You can find it if you go into the library folder. Right here, you can see brushes and shapes right here. Now to make your own, if you wanted, you could do something fancy and then use a lasso select and choose import selection. We've got our own brand new brush shape right here. Now, if we paint with it, you're gonna see we've got that same shape repeating over and over again. Now to understand how shapes work, this square, this 512 by 512 square, we have spacing set at 100. By default, this is gonna be lower. What this is gonna do is that's gonna put that square right next to itself, exactly meeting 100%, one, and then the next with no gap. Now, if we increase this past 100, we're gonna see a larger gap, a 33% gap in between. If we put this at 200, it's going to be two widths in between. If we bring this down to 10, this is going to be overlapping 90%. If we bring this up to 50, this is going to be overlapping 50%. Okay, for the rest of this, let's put this at 100% so we can understand easily what's going on. Let's change this shape to the star. So you can see our star shape is almost touching because it's almost touching the outsides here. Now let's look at grain. Grain is like a lens put over a flashlight. The dark parts are going to block out what comes through, and the white parts are going to let everything through. So white is going to let all of this star shape through. Dark is going to let and block most of the light or paint coming through. And that's the way I like to think about it. It's obviously slightly different than that. So here, if we use a splatter one, you're going to see that because this has high contrast, it's going to really block out some areas and let other areas come through. I have a custom one here, and this one is letting very specific parts through and blocking very specific parts. Now with both shape and grain, and we're going to set this one right here, shape and grain, you have these new properties. So let's go ahead and unpin this, bring it here so we can see it. So here I can scale this up, I can scale it down. Let's put this on white for right now. Along with scale, I can adjust the brightness. And I can adjust the contrast. Now, this is really nice because in the past you would have to do this manually inside of another program or another way and then lasso select and create one with those exact properties. So this gives you a lot more control. Now with that, we can rotate. Now, let's use a different shape here so we can see this. Here we use the splats. Here we can flip it. This is flipping horizontally. You can rotate and then flip horizontally and get another angle. And then we can invert. And invert does exactly what you think it would do. Now you can do the same things here with grain. You can adjust all of these properties to create really cool, very special brushes. Okay, let's decrease the spacing so we can take a look at this brush. It's a very cool brush. Now, this brush that we've created has only one shape and grain pair. So I can click here, add shape and grain. Now we have two pairs and we have an extra option here. Sequential, random, pen pressure, and pen tilt. We're going to start with sequential, and we're going to change number one, number two. We're going to change number two to the star. For the sake of this, let's add one more, and we're going to change it to our first shape that we created together. We're going to change the grain on all of these to something simple so we can understand what's going on. All right, so we have texture order. Let's bring our stroke length back up to 100. And look at what's happening here. So we are sequentially going between all three shape and grain pairs. We could go as high as 4 here, but we're going to keep it at 3. Now, random will do exactly what you think. It will do a random choice on which one comes first. The image sequence you can adjust here. And that's going to increase and decrease the number in the texture order before variance, and then pen pressure. Now this one is pretty neat. So if I press light, I'm only going to get shape 1. Medium, I'm starting to get shape 2. And hard, I'm getting shape 3. And hard, you could say heavy pressure. So now in between here, we have these sliders. Now, if I pull this and create a lot of distance in this slider, what we're going to do is we're going to see this shape and this one blend. Let's go ahead and clear this layer so we can see that. And as I transition, you can see a little bit of the star and a little bit of the splat. And I push further, we can see a little bit of the star and then a little bit of the pattern that we created in the beginning. We want no transitions, everything to jump from one to the next. Then setting it up with no gaps here is exactly how you do that. Pen tilt works the same way. Vertical or perpendicular to the screen, you're going to get the first slot, and then as you tilt, you're going to get more of the other shapes. Now let's bring this back to just 1. And for alpha blending, we need to choose something besides our oils and acrylic brush. So we're going to choose our express oils. And we have an alpha blending option here. Now let's look at the alpha blending property. So you can see right here, we have this set to difference. We're going to set this back to normal. I'm going to point out that alpha blending is not available in all the tools. So if you see here, this is grayed out. You may have to switch to a different tool to see it functional. So we're going to demonstrate it here in the markers section. I've selected this triangle shape. So what I want to note is these are all overlapping 50%, and that's just for this demonstration. Here you can choose normal, lighten, so now if we choose difference, you're going to see this pattern. Every time it overlaps, the places where it's overlapping, the difference is being removed. Now if we bring this stroke back down and choose smudge, we're going to get a very different effect. Turn smudge off. You can see we can create some really trippy brushes this way. That's quite cool. Let's bring the spacing down even further. And let's put pen pressure so it's active. We're going to put pen pressure all the way up here. It's a really cool effect, really cool effect. We'll add a little bit of spacing jitter and a little bit of scatter. You can make some pretty wild things. All right, let's go back to our oil and acrylic brush that we've been playing with. Let's change our shape back to this round shape. make sure that our other properties are set to off so that we see exactly what's affecting what. All right, shape, our angle, for angle, let's choose this flat noisy. You can see it's vertical here. And as we adjust this, this is going to rotate it up to 360 degrees, which should be back to the same starting point. But this gives you the ability to set it whichever angle that you would like. Angle jitter. That's going to make our little brush head dance a little bit. A lot of jitter, or a little bit of angle jitter. And rotation, this is going to do one of a couple things. So follow trajectory, we're going to click on force rotation mode, is going to follow the direction that the brush is going. So you can see this happening here. As I turn, it turns. Now here, if we change the angle to line up, end to end, as we start going, it's going to follow that pattern and allow us to do some really fun things. Pen tilt is going to keep in line with how your pen is tilted. So if I tilt my stylus around, it will keep the shape moving with the tilt. And then if you have a device that has rotation, that is the spinning of the barrel that adjusts the tip here. So if I spun it on the screen, you would see this changing angle all the way around. This force rotation mode, what this does is here in preferences, there is an option for always use pen tilt rotation instead of follow trajectory in brush creator. So what that means is that if I want everything except for the ones that I choose to use pen tilt and rotation, and this is going to help me override that software setting. Now the last function we're going to talk about today is the shape border. So this one can be hard to understand without explanation, so I'm going to go into it with a little bit more detail. So now up here, right here, you can see the shape. And you can see what we're able to do is we're moving the 512 pixel image. This one right here, we can select something different. And we're going to select this small one so we can see here. This is adjusting the pass through. So here, if I place this right in the middle, you can move this up 50% up or down 50% down, which is represented by 100, both negative and positive. Okay, so let's put this right here in the middle, and we're going to draw on the screen so we can see what this looks like. And let's detach this and put this over here. Okay, so what we're seeing here, this thicker impasto, this here is the shape border. Now there's the start, there's the mid, and there's the end. So let's adjust this to the very bottom and take a look at this same thing. What you can see is this area right here is affected. This area right here is affected. The mid section and the end section right here is not affected. So let's go ahead and move this one down and take a look at how this looks different. And you can see now our end right here has been affected. The placement's been affected. The mid, let's move this right here into the middle. Let's clear the layer. And you can see right here, this midsection is being affected. Now you can adjust this with pressure as well. So pressure adds and fills in this deeper impasto, this pass-through of this shape by adjusting light pressure to heavy pressure. Preview of shape is going to show the shape of the brush. That's this one up here. And then what you want to note is that if this shape is too bright, so let's click here on texture properties, let's bring the brightness up, then when we go down here into shape border, we're not going to be able to see, and there's not going to be any contrast in between the thickness, the impasto depth that passes through. So if you want to see the shape border working, make sure that you bring the brightness down enough to see those two things working in contrast with each other. All right, in the next video, we're going to go into grain and talk about all these features here. Stay tuned, stay creative, and I'll see you in the next video.